This video will show you how to use Thermo-Calc to calculate the electrical resistivity and thermal conductivity of pure copper. Over the past several years, many new thermophysical properties have been added to Thermo-Calc databases. This video demonstrates how easy it is to calculate these thermophysical properties in Thermo-Calc with a simple one-axis calculation type. The calculation can be run by anyone with a license for Thermo-Calc 2022B or newer, including those who are using the free educational package. The calculation is based on example T16 of the examples included in your software, which you can access from the example files icon on the home screen, the Thermo-Calc folder, and double-click on example file T16. In this video, I will walk you step-by-step through setting up the calculation. To begin, open Thermo-Calc in the graphical mode and click on the one-axis template from the home screen of Thermo-Calc. This will load all of the nodes we need for this type of calculation. From the Databases drop-down menu, select the AL Demo database, then select the element copper. Next, click on the Phases and Phase Constitution tab. Here, users can select and deselect phases. Deselect all of the phases except for FCC A1 and liquid, since they are the only phases relevant to the current calculation. If you do not know which phases are relevant in a calculation, it is okay to make the calculation without deselecting phases. Our system is now defined, so select the Equilibrium Calculator node, which is where we will configure our calculation. We will accept the default values under Condition Definitions, so make sure your values match mine. Under Axis Definitions, set the temperature range from a minimum of 100 to a maximum of 6,000. Leave all other values the same. Our calculation is now configured, so select the Plot Renderer node, which is where we will select the thermophysical properties. We want to calculate the thermophysical properties as a function of temperature, so we will leave the x-axis variable as temperature, but we will change the limits. Uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the limits of the x-axis from 0 to 3000, stepping at 500. Under the y-axis, click on the drop-down menu for axis variable. Here you can see the range of variables that can be plotted with a one-axis calculation, including many thermophysical properties. Select thermal conductivity, then FCC A1, because we will be calculating the thermal conductivity of this single phase. Uncheck the box next to automatic scaling and set the limits of the y-axis from 200 to 450, stepping at 25. Our calculation is now set, so click Perform at the bottom center of the program. Once the calculation is complete, a plot will appear in the results pane. This plot shows the thermal conductivity of the FCC A1 phase as a function of temperature. If you are running the example file, you will see the experimental data. The calculated curve perfectly agrees with the experimental data and reproduces the nonlinear feature at the low temperature range. Note that copper melts around 1,358 Kelvin, so the calculation above the melting temperature is based on an extrapolation, as there are no data points. Since the data shows a nearly linear temperature dependence at higher temperatures, the extrapolation is considered reliable, although the reliability inevitably decreases with increasing temperature. Next, we will plot the thermal conductivity of the system. First, change the legend option to stable phases, so that we can see which phases are present at each temperature. Under the x-axis, change the upper limit to 6,000 Kelvin. Under the y-axis, select System and change the lower limit to 0. Make sure your values match mine, then click Perform again. This plot shows the thermal conductivity of pure copper over a wide temperature range, covering both the FCC A1 state at lower temperatures and the liquid state at higher temperatures. Such a plot for the system presents the property of the stable phases. If you are running the example file, you will once again see the experimental data. Since this is calculating the system, we no longer see the extrapolated property of FCC A1 above the melting point. Instead, we see a kink around 1,358 Kelvin, which corresponds to the transition from FCCA1 to liquid. In other words, the melting of copper. The thermal conductivity of liquid copper is valid up to 6,000 Kelvin, or even higher. Next, we will plot electrical resistivity, first of the system and then of the FCCA1 phase. Under the x-axis, set the limits from 200 to 2,000, stepping at 200. Under the y-axis, select electric resistivity and set the limits from 0 to 4e to the negative 7, stepping at 5e to the negative 8. Then click perform again. This plot shows the electrical resistivity of pure copper over a wide temperature range, covering both the FCCA1 state at lower temperatures and the liquid state at higher temperatures. Similar to the previous plot, the kink at the melting point clearly shows the abrupt change of electrical resistivity due to the phase transition. Again, if you are running the example file, you will see that the experimental data has excellent agreement with the results. Finally, we will plot electrical resistivity of the FCCA1 phase. Change the legend option to axis quantity. Under the y-axis, select FCCA1 and set the limits from 0 to 2e to the negative 7, stepping at 2e to the negative 8. Then click perform again. This plot shows the electrical resistivity of the FCCA1 phase as a function of temperature. If you are running the example file, you will once again see the experimental data. From the previous plot, we already know that the calculation could accurately reproduce the experimental data of electrical resistivity of solid copper. The current plot for FCCA1, however, allows us to see how the property extrapolates into the high temperature range, where it is no longer stable. The trend is more or less linear, while the high temperature part shows a slightly stronger temperature dependence. We hope you enjoyed this video. You can view many more videos on our website at thermocalc.com in the video tutorials section.